slow, dude.
Okay. Sorry.
Forgive me, I just heard about this open mic a few hours ago, trying to cobble stuff together. Hopefully it'll fly. If it doesn't, just think of it as like Donald Trump's new administration. You just grab a bunch of shit and call it a well-oiled machine. Perhaps mention is the oiled machine he's talking about is actually a large sewer pump. But that's another story. So yeah, so we got any Trump fans out here in the audience?
Yeah!
Here we go, we got one! Now, obviously, I didn't vote for the guy, I demonstrated against him, but I gotta admit, I'm actually starting to like him a little bit. Because he's just so fucking funny. Yeah. I mean, god damn it. I run down the stairs every morning and turn on NPR just to find out what the fuck he said the night before. It's like, he said what? That's fucking hilarious! And then I remember, oh fuck, he's got the nuclear codes. It's like, oh shit! And I'm going from like hysteria to like sheer panic in like microseconds. Like, oh fuck! What the fuck's going on here? And like, I think of it's like we're on an airplane, right? And we're still on the ground. And then you look out the window and you see this big doofus, like an orange beard. You know, he's so funny. And like, he's riding a unicycle and he's got a weird cap on his head. And he's just hilarious. And then, and we're all laughing. And then he's like, you know, he's rubbing his ass up against people's luggage. Leaving a big stain on somebody's Louis Vuitton or something. And it's like, y'all think it's all hilarious. And then he gets on the plane and realizes he's the fucking pilot! It's like, fuck! So that's like, yeah, so the panic back and forth. But he does say weird, funny shit like, you know, leaks are real, but the news is fake. Leaks are real, but the news is, it's the same fucking thing! Leaks and news are the same thing! That's like the steak I mean, he tastes like shit. But the meat and grizzle tastes great. It's like, it's the same fucking thing. I'm gonna like confuse the two. And that's why they like I figure the NSA and the CIA don't like him, because it's like he's too confusing for them. He's like an encryption genius. You know? It's like they've invented this kind of shit since the Enigma machine in World War II. It's like, well, we need to hire new code breakers or something on this guy. And also oh yeah, and like he keeps calling things fake news, like New York Times and CNN calls it the fake news, and I kind of blame his wife for this. You know, think about it, because after years and years of nothing but fake orgasms, no wonder the guy's confused. Try to imagine a volcano reading a newspaper. That was pretty much it. And all those kids would be running around the neighborhood trying to find a virgin to throw at them to keep them from blowing up. And sometimes it worked, and sometimes we kept the virgins for ourselves. What the hell? We had needs too, you know. Also my father, 9 kids, and my father had that classic saying, he's like, we would always break stuff around the house. It was like 9 kids running amok. And my father would actually come out with that, we can't have nice things here. We can't have nice things here. And I remember thinking, no shit. He had 9 kids. What do you think would happen? You want nice things? Try wearing a condom. That's a nice thing. Can't have nice things. He made it sound as if his life ambition was to be a gay antique dealer in Provincetown, where you can have nothing but nice things everywhere. But unfortunately, he was a straight Catholic, so that's what you end up with, a lot of broken shit. But I returned from the West Coast about a year and a half ago to this area, and things are definitely different here. Things are more complicated, like pizza. You know, it can take as many as 5 brothers to make a pizza back here. I fucking drive around, it's 2 brothers pizza, 3 brothers 4, 5 brothers pizza, 5! I mean, what the fuck are you guys doing, making a pizza or building a spaceship, for God's sakes?
Catholic family.
A what?
Building a
Catholic family. Building a spaceship, yeah. It's like 5 brothers, what are they, extremely lazy brothers? It's like, hey, Luigi, you want to make a pizza today? Nah, I'm going to take a nap over here on this big sack of flour. Get Dominic to do it. I'm going to serve some internet porn. You fucking make the pizza. Nobody wants to fucking make any pizza around here. Nobody takes 5 brothers. Oh, and by the way, 5 brothers, a pizza parlor is about the only thing you can call 5 brothers. Right? You can't have 5 brothers chiropractic. A bunch of Italian guys beating the shit out of your back, trying to help money. You're like, ah! Or 5 brothers gynecology. Come on in, ladies, we all want to have a look. So pretty much 5 brothers, it's stuck with the pizza only. It's about as far as you can go with that one. And, I'm trying to eat healthier, too. You guys eat free-range chicken? Free-range chicken? I eat driving range chicken. It's chicken that's killed by falling golf balls at the end of a driving range. I'm not sure if it's healthier, but God damn, that's some tender chicken. It is some tender chicken. And you gotta eat local, right? Everybody's like, well, you gotta eat local these days. You gotta eat local, you gotta eat that local food. You gotta get your milk from Joe the farmer up the street. He's got 2 cows in a garage next to a 52 Buick. That's where you gotta get your milk from. And then there's Mildred with 1 wooden leg and an eye patch. She's got chickens up in her bedroom. That's where you gotta get your eggs. It's local eggs. And the other day I saw this kid pull a booger out of his nose and eat it. I was thinking, that's too local for me, man. That's where I draw the line. Too fucking local. I'm having a hard time sleeping these days, too. It's not because of Trump. I got this new mattress. It's one of those memory foam mattresses. Turns out it has Alzheimer's. Every time I lay down on it, it says, who the hell are you? And then it pisses itself. So. And, I'm getting older and older, and it's like, I gotta do a lot of shit now I've never had to do before. I gotta shave my ears. Yeah, all these hairs going out of my ears now. If I don't shave them, I don't look like a hobbit. And then my prostate's getting bigger and starting to invade aggressively other parts of my body, which is why I've renamed it Vladimir Putin. I figured if he's gonna act like an asshole, I'm not gonna give it an asshole's name. But that's one thing I get, it's just, your prostate inflates on you as you get older. At this point, I just can't wait. I just want to just blow out of my ass like a big balloon. Just blow out of my ass like a big balloon. Because then, Thanksgiving Day, I can float down Broadway with the rest of the floats going, hello, America! I'm Captain Prostate! I love you all! And just floating down, bumping my nose up against underdog's ass. Just a concept I have in my head. Another thing about getting older. You ever notice how old people see things with their teeth? Yeah, I remember when I was a young guy, I saw this old guy looking across the street trying to read a sign on the store. He's like, what you see? Inconvenient! I remember thinking, well, if you would shut your mouth and open your eyes, maybe you'd see it. And now the other day, I'm like walking down the street saying, what time is it? I can't read this fucking thing. So things come full circle. All right, I'll leave it on that. Thank you very much for your time.
Nice job, David.
spit in front of you, that's gotta be pretty damn hard.
So, nice job. And I don't want to say this, but this girl is no virgin to our stage. But, ladies and gentlemen, Anne Marie Rowley.
Shave my legs for this. Thank you.